Children, Om Kumara Kushalo Dayayay Namaha. I'm sure somebody's gonna post the lyrics. Om Kumara Kushalo Dayayay Namaha.
Om Kumara Kushalo. Shalom.
Shalom.
Namaste.
Namaste, friends.
Today we're really celebrating birth and love. So many births. One is that today we started our mantra meditation journey online that I'm sure you all had the information about. And it's for us, it's beautiful to offer it again for everybody who's maybe not done it or not aware of it, or for maybe to do it again, which can always be done again because mantras just go deeper and deeper in the understanding of them as well. And also that they are available in English, obviously, Russian, German and Spanish, so everybody is more included and can really understand also the wise words that we are saying. So welcome if you started today, and if you did start today, why don't you put a Om sign in the comment that we know you or if you are going to start again, put an Om sign in your comment, and then we can wave to each other like that. And so that all the information is in the copy of this post and other posts, how you can join. It's not like this, which is happening at a certain time of the day, but it's available to you anytime really, but it gets uploaded at a certain time of the day, and then you can just do it at your own pace. And 21 days is a magic number, because it's a transformative number. It's in 21 days transformation can happen, new habits can happen, good habits can be formed, and so it's a beautiful auspicious number.
You know, it's that thing about mantras that they are available, but we have to step towards them. We know they're there now, but the step towards them, like this 21 day, is to say, I will do 21 days. So that is your step, because until you make a step into the mantras, they are something else, but they are also, whatever we think they are also something else. And that's the same for all of us. They are, like Dave was saying, we've been chanting mantras now for almost 30 years, you know, and look, they just never get born. They never get in any way
old.
Old, yeah.
They are already old.
Well, they're timeless. They're timeless, that's the point. So to get that experience, we all need to make a step. And this is our, in a way, it's our invitation to you guys who've joined us lately, you know, and you can feel, oh, 21 days, every night before I go to sleep, I will do my meditation, do my mantra meditation. So for a whole 21 days, you do a practice and see how it feels at the end, you know. Then you'll feel like, oh, I want to continue, you know. But until you do that, just do it.
Somebody just said, can you tell the information again? It's in the post, it's in the copy of this Facebook post, Facebook live video. You'll find all the links there. Or somebody said, I'm confused. There's two things happening. There's this daily live online meditation that we're doing right now. As well as that, there is the offering of doing our 21-day mantra meditation journey that we recorded quite a few years ago now. And it's 21 days, every day is a different mantra. There's a guided meditation around each mantra, and then the possibility to sing it, chant it, or listen to it. And it's a real good, it's an introduction into 21 mantras, because it's 21 different ones. And it's going deeper and a real experiencing through the meditation, the guided meditation for each day. So that's the 21-day mantra meditation journey. And the first time we offered it online, 200,000 people signed up for it, which was a beautiful,
amazing
thing. And while we're talking about births, I want to say a big happy birthday to Terry today. So happy birthday to you. right, so then
this is the message now. Sing your own song. Beat your own drum. Fly on the wind, it'll carry you. Dance your own dance. There's no better chance. Fly on the wind, it'll carry you. And why hesitate when there's nothing to fear? Yourself go. Say yes, don't say no. Fly on the wind, it'll carry you. You can sing together. Why hesitate? Why hesitate when there's nothing to fear? Why do we wait with a moment right here? Be your own light, keep your heart strong, and sing your own song. For those of you who've joined us lately, I'll just go over one more time the meditation. But before we go there, let's bring a sense of the sacred to the room that we are in. Let's see this room as our temple. You have your candle, you're a living plant, you have some life energy in there. Oh yeah, David told me not to talk like this, but the microphones are down here, so I just want to make sure you're hearing me, you know. So make our room our temple and get yourself comfortable in your body. You're comfortable in your chair or your seat, if you have your meditation stool, or if you're in lotus. You feel your spine is straight. Our spine is a vehicle in itself, so just having the feeling of a straight spine already brings energetic pulse to our bodies. And this pulse is the pulse that we're looking for when we meditate. We're open to this pulse of life, and it's our heartbeat. So it's slowing down the heartbeat, slowing down for a while. And once we begin to slow down, speeding up begins to feel like something's not necessary. It's good to slow down our lives, good to take time for breathing, good for taking time to look in, having eye contact, keeping our senses clean and clear. Well, this is the gift of meditation. It brings us to a space of inner serenity and a smile, no matter what. So with our eyes closed and bringing our eyes to the center of our forehead, this is our sixth chakra. Bringing your eyes up there, becoming aware that that's a pool of light. Slowing down. Relax your shoulders. Take a deep breath. If you have your mouth closed, relax your mouth for a moment. Relax your jaw. Open your mouth. Relax. And breathing in the belly, in your core. Chant the mantra Om together. We chant the Gayatri mantra and then again the mantra Om, a cosmic yes.
Take a deep breath together and breathe out. In a deep breath, thank you. Swaha Tat Savitur Varinya Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Deho Yo Na Prachodaya. Om Bhurbhuva Svaha Tat Savitur Varinya Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Bhuyo Na Prachodaya. Om Bhurbhuva Svaha Tat Savitur Varinya
for you to sing. Just enjoy your chorus by yourself. It's nice. You're singing together with many people. Let's begin here. Oh, Close your eyes and chant with us.
If your eyes close, it's a good moment to close them. And just like we are all frequency, we are vibration. What we utter, what we sing, is a vibration that's eternal. We've released it into the universe and it's going to be reverberating forever, and I just saw us all like bubbles, you know, like these Om bubbles full of love, releasing them into the universe. So each time we sing the Om, we just have this love connection, and that the Om is coming from our heart center, filled with love. And then the woodpecker joined in with his own version of Om.
That's some karma, huh? To be a woodpecker.
Birth and love, and this is for, there's a few different couples who've written to us who've had anniversaries, and one is Larina and Murti in Hawaii, the 10 years together. Love you guys, all blessings to you, nice to be connected. And then there is Joyce and Remco, who are 25 years together, and all love and blessings to you. And then there is Evelyn and Reinhard with 49 years together. All blessings and love to you guys. And then yesterday, something so beautiful happened. Katrin wrote and she said, you know what? I'm going to marry myself. I have a celebration where I'm going to marry myself. And this is so touching and so beautiful. And and I feel we all really should be having that awareness of being married to ourselves and to be our own, you know, like that we are, we feel complete in ourselves. And also for those of you who feel like, oh, I want to be in a long relationship, or just remember, if it's not happening, it's not needed at this moment, and it's all good, and it all happens or doesn't happen in its right time. And I always have to remember that Miten was 40, he had to wait 43 years to meet me. I mean, you just never, you never know, you just never know. And just to not be sad, it's all good, it's all in perfect divine order.
And that's why that lady, what she said was so beautiful. She said that she was looking for a husband to marry, and then she, this year, she felt like, oh, wait a minute, that's it, I'm just going to love myself. And I'm just going to marry myself, because that's the key. You know, every relationship is just a key into our own being. That's what it is. And it's a reflection. And if you can get there without all the mess, fantastic. I honestly, you know, when I think of, again, Osho gave me the name Prabhu Miten, and it was so auspicious for me, because I honestly didn't have any. It was Prabhu Miten means a friend of God, and it was Osho's way of giving me the eternal reminder to be a friend to yourself, to be a friend, to befriend the godliness, to befriend the friend in the Sufi term. And so these are, you know, this beautiful, a beautiful way to see it. We need, the only thing we need is to love ourselves, and the only way we can do that is to look deeply inside ourselves, and the only way we can do that is through meditation. So that's the, that's basically the trip, you know. And once we get into it, nothing else is can touch that sense of peace and that sense of inner contentment and gratitude. So let's love each other, let's love ourselves from a point of, like they say, it's the love for yourself that you share.
They say that?
Somebody said that.
And if you're thinking, oh, these guys can talk easy, they're together, and then they say it's all okay if you're alone. We have, each one of us has been also alone and longing for that. I totally know that space of longing for that beloved. And so just so know, we have experienced that too, and at the moment we're experiencing something else, and that's, who knows how long, that's the other thing, we just have only the moment, and there's no forever. Or,
and don't hold back your love, you know, don't hold it back waiting for something, love yourself right now. A beautiful book I can recommend is by a great Persian poet called Hafiz. Hafiz. Tonight the subject is love. I think that's what the book is called. Tonight the subject is love, by the Sufi Persian poet Hafiz. If you're longing for something, I would suggest you get that book and enjoy
the
sweetness of the longing that we feel. It's very beautiful. And for all
of us,
all of us, and especially for my friend Maniko, if ever you're watching this, Maniko, you gave us one of the most beautiful songs. And,
yeah, and also Maniko is somebody that we can really recommend if you want to have singing lessons in the spirit of what we're doing, somebody who can help you on a more technical level than we can. Wow, that's such a beautiful bird there, if you could see it. Wow, it's orange and black.
Wow.
I've never seen it. Wow. She gives singing lessons also via Skype, and it's really in the spirit of meditation and voice and chakras and,
oh, she's
and
great.
Like a path. So she's called Maniko, and the website is templeofsong.com. Templeofsong.com. Very recommended. She wrote this song.
Is she with me?
In the light of love, we are whole. In the light of love, we are.
We sing together.
Om Shri Dhanvantre Namaha.
Sing with me now.
Om Shri Dhanvantre. Samasta sukino bhavantu loka samasta sukino bhavantu loka samasta sukino bhavantu Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino
Namaste. Thank you.